गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू द वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड ऑपरेशन मैनेजमेंट। ओके, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट, अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मैथमेटिकल अप्रोच। ओके, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्राफिकल मेथड्स। ओके, इन एग्रीगेट प्लानिंग देर आर टू मेथड्स, वन इज ग्राफिकल मेथड्स एंड सेकेंड वन इज मैथमेटिकल मेथड्स विच वी हैव लर्न इन द लास्ट लेक्चर, लाइक मेथड्स फॉर एग्रीगेट प्लानिंग। अंडर दिस पॉइंट वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द ग्राफिकल मेथड्स। नाउ इट्स टाइम्स टू लर्न अबाउट द मैथमेटिकल अप्रोच। लाइक मैथमेटिकल अप्रोच कवर फोर पॉइंट्स। विच आर दिस फोर पॉइंट्स? लाइक ट्रांसपोर्टेशन मेथड ऑफ लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग, मैनेजमेंट कोएफिशिएंट मॉडल, सिमुलेशन एंड लीनियर डिसीजन रूल्स एंड कंप्यूटर मॉडल। दिस आर द मैथमेटिकल पॉइंट्स विच वी हैव टू लर्न अंडर द एग्रीगेट प्लानिंग। वी आर फुली अवेयर अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ एग्रीगेट प्लानिंग। ओके, ओवरऑल प्लानिंग ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, इट्स कॉल्ड एग्रीगेट प्लानिंग। एंड अंडर दैट वी आर यूजिंग द मैथमेटिकल अप्रोच टू फोकसिंग ऑन द एग्रीगेट प्लानिंग, इट्स कॉल्ड मैथमेटिकल अप्रोच। ओके, ग्राफिकल मेथड्स वी हैव लर्न in our last lecture. Now it is time to learn about the mathematical approach. Here mathematical approach, some mathematical approaches have been devised in the last 50 years to aggregate planning, or we can say that from the last 50 years we are using the aggregate mathematical approach for the aggregate planning. Here are the mathematical approach such as transportation method of linear programming produce an optimal plan for minimizing cost, or one among them is the transportation method of linear programming. This approach is a way of solving or producing an optimal plan for minimizing cost. When aggregate planning problem involves the problem of allocating operating capacity to meet the forecasted demand, one can use the linear programming format. It can specify regular and overtiming production in each time period, the number of units to be subcontracted, extra shifted, and inventory carry over from period to period. However, this method does not work well when negative factors or non-linear factors like layoffs, hiring, etc. are used. In such a case, the more general linear programming method need to be used, or linear programming we are using in the mathematical approach. Mathematical approach can use the linear programming. Under the linear programming, we can easily find out the number of quantity we would like to produce in the organization for the particular duration of the time, etc., etc. point we can easily clear with this mathematical approach, or here we can say that it is the transportation method of linear programming. Okay, another mathematical model is management coefficient model, which is a formal planning model built around a manager's experience and performance. The past performance of a manager can be used as a basis for future decisions. Here we can say that whatever data we have collected related to the past, and this past data we can formulate as a tabular form and predicting the future things on the basis of past data. So these types of mathematical approach cover the management coefficient model, or we can use the word management coefficient model because here we are using the manager's experience, their past data. On the basis of their past experience, on the basis of their past data, they can predicting the future activities. So these types of approach under the mathematical approach called management coefficient model, a formal model built around a manager's experience and performance. Or here these techniques use regression analysis. Regression analysis is nothing but back analysis or past analysis. So here this technique uses regression analysis of past production decision made by managers. The regression line provides the relationship between variables like demand and labor for future decision. ओके. नाउ द नेक्स्ट थर्ड मैथमेटिकल अप्रोच इज द लीनियर डिसीजन रूल दैट अटेम्प्ट टू स्पेसिफाई एन ऑप्टिमम प्रोडक्शन रेट एंड वर्कफोर्स लेवल ओवर अ स्पेसिफिक पीरियड. सम अदर मॉडल्स आर लीनियर डिसीजन रूल्स एंड सिम्युलेशन. सिम्युलेशन मीन्स उत्तेजित करूँ. ओके. सिम्युलेशंस. लीनियर डिसीजन रूल्स इज अ टेक्निक विच स्पेसिफाई एन ऑप्टिमल रेट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड वर्कफोर्स लेवल ओवर अ स्पेसिफिक पीरियड. इट मिनिमाइजिज द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ पेरोल, हायरिंग, लेऑफ्स, ओवर टाइम एंड इन्वेंटरी थ्रू अ सीरीज ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक कॉस्ट कर्व. ओके. सो दिस इज द मैथमेटिकल अप्रोच लाइक लीनियर डिसीजन रूल्स. हियर वी कैन से दैट इट इज वन टाइप ऑफ एवरेज पॉइंट ऑफ production which we have to stimulate for the future decision. So these types of method called simulations or linear decision rule and simulation. And the last point under the mathematical approach is scheduling by simulations which use a search procedure to look for the minimum cost combinations of value for workforce size and production rate. A computer model, you can say that the computer model. Okay, so here the computer model we are using, a computer model called scheduling by simulation uses a search procedure to find minimum cost combinations of value for workforce. Sys means one type of matter and production rate. Here we are using the computer or the latest technology for the future predictions. So scheduling by simulations which uses a search procedure to look for the minimum cost combinations of value for workforce size and production rate. Or ultimately we can say that we are using the computer for the future prediction, for the future aggregate planning. Clear? So these are the techniques or these are the approach covered under the mathematical approach. Clear till here? If any students have any doubt in this point, please feel free to ask. These are the main important point which we have learned under the mathematical approach. Last lecture we have learned about the graphical methods. Under the graphical methods we have known that how we are using the graph for the future predictions. And now in the mathematical approach we can say that we are using the proper data, proper information for the future planning. So these types of techniques cover under the four sub points. Like first one is the transportation method of linear programming, management coefficient model, simulations and linear decision rules, and computer model. So these are the four mathematical approaches we are using under the aggregate planning. Clear till here? Now the next point is aggregate planning in services. Aggregate planning in services. Yeah, aggregate planning in services. Aggregate planning in services, it involves developing, monitoring and sustaining an organization's operational schedule. It arranges areas of business that consist of targeted sales, predictions, level of production, customer background and inventory levels. In service, demand management plays an active role in according in conducting aggregate planning. Here in simple word we can say that in services, demand management plays an active role in conducting aggregate planning. Most service formulate mixed aggregate planning strategies, and aggregate planning tend to be easier in bank and fast food joint than in a manufacturing. Controlling cost of labor is important in service firm, and it includes a schedule labor hours accurately so that customer demand can be responded to. B, we can say that flexibility to add or delete a labor resources to meet unexpected demand or call labor. Here the flexibility to recall available labor by ensuring flexibility in worker skill. And the last point we can say that flexible hours of work to meet changing demand. However, in service industries, labor is the basic aggregate planning vehicle. Approaches to aggregate planning differ by the service provided. For instance, police and fire department have provision for calling in of duty employees for emergencies. and may work longer hours, shift in case of extended emergencies. However, in restaurant and retail stores, when business is slow, employees are sent home early. Similarly, in supermarket, stock clerk work as cashier when the customer lines for building become too lengthy. So different services faces different problem in aggregate planning, like hospital face aggregate planning problems in allocating money, staff and supplies to meet the demand of patient, like airlines and auto rental firm have unique aggregate scheduling problems, like number of flights in and out of each base centers, a number of flights on all routes, number of passengers to be served on all flights, number of air personnel and ground staff required at each center. So these are the examples of aggregate planning in services. Here the scheduling labor hours accurately so that the customer demand can be responded, flexibility to add or delete a labor resources to meet unexpected demand, flexibility to allocate available labor by ensuring flexibility in worker skills, flexible hours of work to meet changing demand. Okay, and also we have discussed the example of aggregate planning. Okay, because when we are using the aggregate planning in the service sectors, that time we are facing many problems, because here we are not providing any types of product, but we are providing the services. So these types of services we can use, we can provide with the help of employees, with the help of human resources. And so that we have to manage this the human resources under the aggregate planning in the services. So here airline and auto rental firm, police and fire department, supermarket, hospitals, every service organization facing the different problem in the aggregate planning. For example, in the airline and auto rental firm, we have discussed this point in detail. Like police and fire department have no time limits, many times they can call at emergency. So that we can say that every service department has a different problems which they have to face in the organization, but it is necessary for the organization to provide these types of services in the market. So different services face the different problem, and all the problems can be managed under the help of human resources. That's why it is the very important point for the aggregate planning in services. Clear till here? Why aggregate planning in services? Because in the services we are not providing any product, but we are providing services to our customers. So that here we have to manage the human resources as per the demand, as per the supply of the product or services. So that different services allocating the different way of services in the organization. The next point is capacity planning. Before going to start this point, we must clear about the meaning of capacity, because many times we are using this word as a capacity, like the capacity of the machineries is 100 products in a day, or the capacity of the layout is managing 200 products, or capacity of godown is 1000 bags, etc. point we are using, or capacity of the particular department is producing the particular number of product. So capacity is nothing but maximum level of output can be generated by the organization. It's called capacity. Okay, after selection of production process, an operation manager is faced with the problem of determining capacity, or we have to decide what is the capacity of the organization, or how many products we can produce in the near future. It is based on capacity. So capacity is very important factor for us. So here we can say that we are using the different word for the different services under the capacity wise, because when we are providing in the service center, in the service aggregate planning, that time we are using the different word of providing the capacity or providing the product to the market. So here capacity in general meaning the maximum production rate of a facility or plant. Maximum production rate, how many products we are able to produce in the organization for the near future. For example, for next 20 days, we are able to produce only 20,000 of the products. So the capacity of the unit is 20,000 products in the next 20 days and the 1,000 products in a day. It is the capacity of the organization. It indicates volume of output per period of time. Okay, so volume of output per period of time, it's called capacity. In a service organization, it indicates the number of units a facility can hold, receive or store in a period of time. In a simple word, we can say that in a fixed duration, how many products we are able to produce or sell, it's called capacity. So this decision is very important for an operation manager since it helps in determining capital requirement, which involves a fixed cost element. Capacity also help in determining whether the facility would be sufficient to meet customer demand in a timely manner or whether facilities would remain idle if it is too large and thereby add to existing cost of production or operation. Hence, determining an appropriate facility size capacity is important for earning a high rate of investment as well as for fulfilling the objective of high capacity utilization. Okay, so capacity planning is the process of determining the production capacity needed by an organization to meet changing demand for its products. In the context of capacity planning design, capacity is the maximum amount of work that an organization is capable of completing in a given period. It's called capacity planning. Capacity planning can be done in three time horizons, like long-term capacity planning, medium-term capacity planning, and short-term capacity planning. Here we can easily understand the concept by its word. Like long-term capacity is more than 1 year, medium-term capacity is 3 to 18 months, and short-term capacity is up to 3 months or less than 3 months of capacity. Clear? So here we can give this point as a capacity planning can be done in three time horizon. It is the time horizon, like long term, medium term and short term. Long term means when we are deciding the capacity of the organization for the more than 1 year. The production capacity of the organization is for the predicting for the more than 1 year is called long term capacity. When we are deciding for the month wise, like 3 months to more than 3 months and less than 18 months of capacity, we have to decide in the organization, it's called medium term capacity. And short term capacity is we are deciding for the maximum 3 months of capacity of the organization, it's called short term capacity. Okay, so here long term capacity, it is a function of adding facility and equipment that have long lead time. Okay, or medium term capacity, when we can add equipment, personnel and shift, we can subcontract or build or use inventory. This is aggregate planning task. And short term capacity, where we schedule jobs and people and allocate machineries, we use capacity that is already existing, and modifying capacity is difficult. So capacity can also be explained as like fixed capacity, adjustable capacity, design capacity or install capacity, system capacity, potential capacity, immediate capacity, efficient capacity and normal and actual capacity. So these are the types of capacity we can use. The word capacity can be explained as follow, like fixed capacity, adjustable capacity, design capacity or install capacity, system capacity, potential capacity, immediate capacity, effective capacity, normal or average capacity and actual or utilized capacity. So we will learn this point in detail. Like start with the first point. What is first point is fixed capacity. Fixed capacity is the total capital assets of a company at a particular time is known as fixed capacity. It represents upper limit to the internal capacity that a company can use to meet its demand. It can be easily changed in intermediate range time horizon. it's called fixed. When we are deciding the number of unit we are able to produce in the fixed duration with a fixed capacity, with a fixed inventory, it's called fixed capacity. Second one is adjustable capacity. Adjustable capacity is the size of workforce, number of hours per week they work, and number of shift and extent of subcontracting, or ultimately we can say that change the number of services done by the employees in the organization. When there is a high demand, that time we can use the higher number of hours of the employees in the organization and able to producing the as per the demand. So we can adjust these things as per the demand. That's why these types of capacity called adjustable capacity. Design capacity or installed capacity, it is the planned rate of output of goods services under normal or full scale operating conditions. It sets maximum limit and helps in determining actual utilization of capacity. Here we can say that whatever machineries we have installed in the organization, whatever the space we have used in the organization, so that we have designed, we have fixed, ultimately we have installed the capacity. If we want to increase the capacity, we have to install more machineries and increase the space of the organization so that we can increase the capacity. So it is, we can say that design capacity or installed capacity. Fourth one is system capacity. It is less than or equal to the design capacity. It is the maximum output of a specific product or product mix that the system or the machine workers is capable of producing. It is one type of design capacity, but we are changing the system as per the production requirement. So here the system is less than or equal to the design capacity. It is the maximum output of a specific product or product mix that the system is capable or producing. Now the fifth point is potential capacity. Potential capacity is that which can be made available within the decision horizon of top management. When the top management will decide that we want to increase the capacity of the organization, then they can increase by recruiting the number of employees, by purchasing the more raw material, so that we can say that this whole system is on the hand of top level of the organization. So potential capacity is the capacity that can be made available within the current budget, which can be made available within the decision horizon of top management. Now sixth point is immediate capacity. Immediate capacity is the capacity that can be made available within the current budget period, or budget wise we are changing the requirement of the capacity. So these types of capacity called immediate capacity. Seventh is effective capacity. Effective capacity is the operating or practical capacity. It usually range from 75% to 85% of maximum theoretical installed or design capacity. This is due to loss of capacity due to machine breakdown, preventive maintenance, or delay due to scheduling. Thus the efficient attained is always less than 100%. Moreover there would also be loss of output due to rejections and scrap. We can say that our capacity is 100 products in a day, but we are not able to every time producing 100 products in a day, but 75 to 85 number of the products in a day, because there are many problems we are facing in day-to-day life. So these types of capacity called actual effective capacity, or actually how many products we are able to producing in the organization, it's called effective capacity. Eighth point is normal or average capacity. Normal or average capacity, we can say that next 30 days we are producing, like many times we are producing 75 products in a day, then 85 products in a day, 90 products in a day, 65 products in a day, and at the end average of the product per day is 72. So it is the average capacity or the normal capacity of the organization. We can use the word. So here the average capacity of a plant is the estimated quantity of output or production that should be achieved as per the estimation done by industrial engineering department. Example, a steel plant may have a rated capacity of 1 lakh tons of steel per month. Okay, last point is actual or utilized capacity. This is expressed as a percentage of rated capacity. It is the actual output achieved during a particular time period. The actual output may be less than rated output due to factors like employees absenteeism, low productivity level, actual demand for the product, or any other inefficiencies. System efficiency is the ratio of actual measure output of goods and services to the system capacity. Thus, capacity of a plant can be expressed as the rate of output or unit per day or per week or per month, ton per month, allocate per hours, labor per hours, etc., etc. So actually, what is the capacity we are producing in the organization? So this is the 9 point which shows us the capacity can be explained as follow. So we can explain the capacity is under the 9 sub points. Which are these sub points? Like fixed capacity, adjustable capacity, design capacity or install capacity, system capacity, potential capacity, immediate capacity, effective capacity, normal or average capacity, actual or utilized capacity. Okay, that's all for today's lecture. Next point we will learn in the next lecture. If any students have any doubt, please feel free to ask. In the next lecture, we will discuss the importance of capacity decision. Clear till here? That's all for today's lecture. Thank you.